It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. IPOB leadership is broken. There are many versions of IPOB, Professor Odinkalu. Over the years, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, has been fighting for the freedom of Biafran people so that they can be free from the control of the Nigerian government. He has maintained that IPOB works with the chain command and control. That is why the leadership of IPOB cannot be broken by anybody. He maintained that nobody can destroy the IPOB leadership because it is built on solid foundation, which is the truth. In another development, the former chairman of Nigeria's National Human Rights Commission, NHRC, Chidi Odinkalu, have said that the leadership of the indigenous people of Biafra has broken because there are many versions of IPOB. This was contained in a press statement issued by Chidi Odinkalu during an interview on Arise TV. While interviewed by the press, he said in quotes, IPOB have destroyed its leadership style because there are different types of IPOB. IPOB today is not limited to Nnamdi Kanu alone, but there are many versions of IPOB. The indigenous people of Biafra command and control structure has broken down because there are many types of IPOB currently existing. There are multiple IPOBs, which some of them are political in nature, while some of them are fighting for Biafra. Continuing with his speech, he said, IPOB leadership is totally in disarray right now because the chain of their leadership is broken. The leadership of IPOB is in shambles as most of them belongs to Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, while some of them belongs to the political stakeholders in Igbo land. While describing different types of IPOB, he said, there are political IPOB owned by partisan political actors in Anambra State, and there is a faction of people in Anambra Central who are masquerading themselves as IPOB members. There are political IPOB members who are being controlled by political leaders in Abia State. There are sets of IPOB members that belongs to Mazi in Nnamdi Kanu, while some other members of IPOB belongs to the political leaders in Igbo land. This was a press statement issued by Professor Chidi Odinkalu. President Muhammadu Buhari said his Turkish counterparts have set an example to the rest of the world on how to treat refugees. I commend Your Excellency for leadership and generosity in receiving and accommodating 4 million refugees fleeing from conflict areas, particularly in Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan. You have indeed set an example to the rest of the world, the Nigerian leader said. President Muhammadu Buhari described the 2 days visit of President Erdogan and the First Lady Emini Erdogan as a reflection of the robust, warm and cordial bilateral relation between Nigeria and Turkey. He noted that it was the second time he has had the pleasure of receiving many brothers in Abuja. On the accomplishments from the visit, President Muhammadu Buhari said, during the visit, we held very useful discussions on a number of bilateral issues aimed at discussing germane matters and strengthening the cordial relationship between Nigeria and Turkey. The key issues we touched on included a series of bilateral agreements and memoranda of understanding that had been finalized. As a positive outcome, either major agreements, MOUs on a number of the key sectors including energy, defense industry, mining, and hydrocarbons, among others, were signed today. We have agreed that implementation is to commence immediately. In the course of our discussions, we also reviewed the travel ban list based on the revised COVID-19 protocols and removed Turkey from Nigeria's travel ban list. Turkey has indeed achieved remarkable success in addressing the COVID-19 pandemic. President Muhammadu Buhari said President Erdogan's meeting with a joint session of the Nigeria and Turkish Chambers of Commerce and Industry before departing Nigeria would actually be an opportunity to engage and exchange views on more productive ways of pushing ahead the socio-economic ties between the two countries. He thanked the Turkish President and First Lady for commissioning the Turkish Cultural Center in Abuja, as well as opening the newly renovated government secondary school in Wuse, Abuja, undertaken by the Turkish Cooperation and Coordination Agency, SICA. In his remarks,
President Erdogan stressed that Turkey was determined to improve relations with Nigeria to higher levels on the fields, where President Muhammadu Buhari had actually hosted the President Recep Tayyip Erdogan of the Republic of Turkey in a two-day official visit to Nigeria. President Erdogan also said that the trade volume between both countries reached $2 billion in 2020, making Nigeria the outstanding and biggest trading partner in sub-Saharan Africa. However, we still believe that this level of trade we have achieved is far from being adequate. We hope and pray that we will be expanding our trade volume up to $5 billion immediately. We hope that the relations between the two nations will be further developed on the basis of a win-win scenario and mutual respect. The president, who spoke through an interpreter, said, commiserating with Nigeria on the attack in Goronyo, local government area of Sokoto State, which claimed several lives, the Turkish leader pledged that his country would further cooperate with Nigeria on counter-terrorism as well as in fields of military defense and security. We are ready to share our over-expanding capabilities with Nigeria, especially in the field of defense, industry, and security, which has been praised by the entire globe. This sensitivity that we have showcased in fighting terrorism, I hope, will be reciprocated by our Nigerian brothers and sisters and counterparts, he said. The Turkish president announced that his country has increased its diplomatic presence in Africa to 43 missions, adding that the third round of the Turkish African Business Forum will be held in Istanbul this October, while the third Turkish African Partnership Summit will follow in December. President Erdogan expressed delight that many Nigerian students are currently studying in Turkey and benefiting from scholarship as well. And this is President Recep Tayyip of Turkey, after the President Muhammadu Buhari of our own country had actually signed some bilateral agreement with them. And, the President was actually commending President Muhammadu Buhari for his generosity and also receiving him and also accommodating 4 million refugees that fled from Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan, saying that he has set an example to the rest of the world, where the president described the 2 days visit as a time to reflect and then on robust, warm, and cordial bilateral relation between Turkey and Nigeria, where he noted that in terms of MOUs, defense industry, because the 8 major keys that I actually discussed about was rallying about energy, defense industry, mining, hydrocarbons, among others, and they signed the hood and they signed them, in the bid to ensure that there is a further cordial relationship between the two countries. In the course of their discussions, the President Muhammadu Buhari also stated that they had removed Turkey from Nigeria's ban list, saying that Turkey has actually achieved a remarkable success in addressing COVID-19 pandemic. Thanks for listening.